Welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we are going to look into this anchor design and how to get a rope wrapped around the shape. Are you ready? Let's get started. We're going to use the commands called picture, and you can bring in any reference image that you have there. Deciding what size you want it first, and then you kind of want it to move it from this point or anything that you think is right in the middle, and just type it 0 there, so that will be symmetrical. And we only need to deal with a half of it. Now, once you have it and into the size that you want it, and then you want to lock the object, we want to get it as close as possible and type it 0, and I'm going to go from here. This is a basic form. You don't have to have it exactly the same, or you can change it later if you want to, but I basically want to do something like this, get it as close to the form as possible, and we can change it later if we don't like it. And I also like to do is make sure that I can align to the button. So make sure that your smart track is on and snapping into this endpoint, and then moving up your mouse up. So that way you can make sure the very last point is actually aligned with the bottom one. And just want to make sure this is a nice and round. So I'm going to move it up something like this. Okay, so that's one size, it's done. The reason I have it this open is because I want it to be nice and round. So instead of just using the fillet, I like to use the blend tool and to blend from here to here. Okay, so now we get that finish. We also need to have another curve. It's going to go from here to here. And again, I want to leave it open so I can blend it to have a really nice and round form there. All right, and then let's use the blend tool, and we want to blend it from this end to that end. Okay, so now we have this one left. We can trace over, or we can use the arc tool and snapping it to the endpoint and the endpoint here and coming up like that. Okay, so this will be the shape that we have. Also on the top right here, so we're gonna draw the arc first. We're gonna snap in here, holding the shift, so then they will be the same height. If it is hard for you to get it exactly the shape you want, we can always create whatever. And moving down with this point, close, something like that. Okay, once we have that, we are going to mirror to the other side, something like this, and you can move this up a little bit to close the shape. We're gonna use the arc tool one more time and snapping here to here and gonna bring out like this, and then we are going to mirror to the other side and to get something like this. The last things we need to do is this curve, but I'm just gonna go ahead to hide the background first. Let's deal with this shape first. Mirror that to the other side. Let's go ahead to join all those curves there, and I do actually want to split with the point on this point over here and coming to the top somewhere over there. Okay, so then we separate them top and the bottom. And we do want to make an arc by snapping to the endpoint, to this endpoint, and we want to move it down something like this. Okay, so that will be the bottom part. Now we need to make a profile to show the how deep that we want. So let's go ahead to snapping into the endpoint right here and coming to the right side. I'm going to move it up like this and coming over roughly about 2 millimeters or less, depends on your design. And you're gonna coming over here and move it down something like this. All right, and you can modify the design if you want to, and but that's showing how thick that is going to be. To easier for you to understand, I'm going to snapping into this point and draw a straight line intersect with the curve we just draw. So let's go ahead to split this one with this line so we get that bottom over there. So we're going to give it a try. Let's do sweep to rail, rail one, rail two, cross section, and you get something like this. All right, and then for the second part, we cannot sweep all the way to there. It's because this sharp corner there. So we need to create another curve. Let's go ahead to snapping into this endpoint and to somewhere here. And then we will go to the right view and to create an arc, slightly caving, something like this. So we are going to sweep to rail one, rail two, and this is the cross section. So you get something like that, and we are going to finish with this rail 1, rail 2, and the same cross section. Let's take a look on the render view and see if this is the shape that you like. If you like this shape, we can just join them. And then let's mirror to the other side. Alright, so now we finish this one and double check if that is the shape that you like. Now that's working on this part, we are going to join all of this. We are gonna split with the point right at this point. So we got two rail, and we need to decide it where is the, and we need to decide the cross section. So I'm going to come in over here and to draw something right here and roughly look like this, coming over here and coming back to align with my first point there. And this will be my cross section, but I need to move that cross section to those point. So the command I'm going to use under the transform, you have the orient to point and make sure scale 3D, and you actually don't need a copy. So we're gonna go from here to here and snapping from here to here. All right, so this is our cross section. We are going to use a sweep to rail one more time, rail one, rail two, cross section, and that's how you get this shape there. Now all we need to do is to creating a surface by clicking that curve there, and we're gonna go extrude a curve straight, and then we are going to use that surface to trim off the extra that we have here, and at the same time we're gonna use this surface to trim the extra over there. So now you can join those two surfaces. So to make them into solid, if this is like really thin to you, you can actually make them a bit thicker. You can pick up the curve that we have and you can extrude it, the surface straight, and depends on how deep you want it to have. Let's say I'm going to do 1 millimeter for the thickness, and this one as well, I'm going to extrude it for 1 millimeter. So that way you can create a thickness there. And if you like everything, just go ahead to join everybody, and we can cap this one and also cap this one. So they both become solid. We can bowling it later. We just need to mirror this one to the other side. Okay, so now we have that. This one in the middle is quite simple. We have all those curves over there. First of all, I would like to join everybody and kind of give it a fit at the corners. And I want creating a profile. I'm gonna use the arc tool. Snapping to the quadrant here, coming into the right view, and make a cross section there. So I'm going to split this one with the point right at here and here. And we are going to use a sweep to rail, rail one, rail two. And you're gonna starting with the point, the end point right here, going to the middle, coming back to the end point one more time. And then you will get something like this. Now, if this is the position that you want, that's fine. If you feel like you want them to be more pronounced like this, you can just move it up. And then we want to have this curve and this curve join back together, and we want to extrude it straight. So then we will have the thickness as well. Let's join it, and cap it. So the very last things that we wanted to do is to create this curve over there. So what I like to do is to come over to the top view, and I'm going to draw a line, follow this rope here. Try not to snap in anything. So I try to go by the middle of the rope, and so it will look like this. Alright, so now we have that, we need to kind of move it up and down. So let's turn on the control point. And then for the curve over here, maybe those three, I want them to move higher. So it's gonna go like this. So this coming into the front, right? And then then they go in past that, so the point roughly about here need to go behind the shape, and this one is gonna go in lower. And when they coming into somewhere here, those need to be higher, so I'm going to move those up and try to make it as smooth as possible. And also you don't want them to be like way too high. And then the very last one is go behind it. So we want this to go behind that piece and will be something like this. Okay, so you got the curve that is wrapping around. So first of all, we need to know how long is this piece. So we want to type a command length, and it is 33.564 millimeter, right? We want to make a copy over there. Then we want to create a straight line right here, and that is the same length that with the curve that is wrapping around. Alright, so this is where we are going to create our rope. I'm going to hide the drawing so it's easier for us to see. And then I'm kind of coming over here to draw a circle. To draw a circle over there, and this circle, it can be any size, but try to keep it proportionally close to what we have over there. And let's go ahead to trim each other. And I always like to give in a very nice small fillet. So let's give in a fillet for about 0.1 millimeter, something really nice. So it doesn't look like too sharp on the rendering. So go ahead to join them, and then I wanted to align them right in the center. So something like this, and have that shape that we just have. We wanted to make it into the solid by extruding straight and snapping into the end. So the next things we wanted to do is we need to twist it. So now let's go ahead to snapping into this end to this end, and I want to go like maybe 6 or 8, I don't know, I just need to try and see which one work better. And then so we get something like that. All right and then notice that this, and notice that it is tight right in the middle, but it's getting really loose at the end, and I'm wanted to actually go from really tight the end to end. So let me do one more time, and this time when we do the twist command, we want to go from this end to this end. And when we try to turn, we want it to infinity equal yes. We want to preserve the structure, yes, and make sure both of them click yes. I'm going to try about 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. And then so I will get something like this, right? So that will be evenly from beginning to the end. All right, so now we have this. We need to have that going around this shape that we have it there. So we are going to use a transform, and we are going to flow along curve This will be the object, and that is the base curve, that is the target curve. So we can have a shape like this. And you can adjust it more if you don't feel it flow really well. So that's our anchor tutorial with the Rhino 6. I hope you enjoy it. If you are interested to learn Rhino in more systematic way, I have a few courses on my website. You are welcome to check it out. Thank you for watching and see you next.